As you could hear, my vacuum cleaner doesn't really work anymore. And the reason is that my DIY 3D printed impeller suction system thingy I created in a previous video simply broke. The sad thing is that this happened thanks to only one fall of the vacuum. But the good thing on the other hand is that I now have the chance to redesign the impeller system, to hopefully finally make it better than the original one. And I better succeed this time, because my girlfriend said this is my last chance before I have to buy a new vacuum cleaner from a specific brand, pretty much everyone suggested in the comment section of the last video. And speaking of comment section, I feel more confident this time, because a viewer named Marco reached out to me to do the designing part. And oh boy, there were quite a few changes. And the results were certainly interesting. So let's not waste any more time and let's get started. This video is sponsored by Rode & Schwarz, your trusty electronics test and measuring equipment manufacturer that I can highly recommend. And today I want to tell you about their free radio frequency webinar, in which you can not only learn about the basics of electromagnetic fields, antennas, digital or analog modulation, but also about the super complex stuff that luckily gets explained very well. If that sounds like your cup of tea, then click the link below and learn something new today. Now first off, let's go back to the original motor impeller system the vacuum came with and address the elephant in the room lots of viewers mentioned last time, known as static pressure, which is apparently more important than the airflow I so far measured. Because when it comes to the vacuum suction function, then apparently static pressure is more important. So I will need to somehow measure that to properly compare all the impeller designs. To do that, you can get yourself such a manometer, but since using that is boring, I rather copied a fun looking method from the RC test flight channel. For that, I simply had to design an adapter piece, 3D print it with TPU flexible filament, attach it very snugly to the original impeller system, secure a hose to the other side, and place that into a bucket of water before powering everything up. Now I know it is hard to see due to the green hose, but trust me when I say that the motor and impeller was able to move the water upwards. And what I did here was basically measuring how far the water got pulled upwards at what voltage and power. And these results will be the benchmark values the DIY designs have to beat. So let's start this comparison with my old impeller design, that now looks a bit different though, especially when it comes to securing it to a motor. The reason is that I switched from an outrunner BLDC motor to this inrunner BLDC motor. This way, mounting the motor is not only way easier, but since all the heat generating coils are directly connected to a big heatsink, it will also not have as many problems with overheating. I could also choose a higher kV rating for the motor, which means that with 20 volts later on, it should spin faster than the original motor. But of course, with a new motor, we also have to redesign the motor mounts, and that is exactly what Marco did for me. And as you can see, everything still fits perfectly fine inside the vacuum enclosure. You probably also already noticed that this time I'm using a VESC for controlling the motor. And there were quite a few reasons for that. For one, you can adjust its parameters with a given software and thus fine-tune the settings for your specific motor. And then you can also set an undervoltage limit so that later everything shuts off if my battery gets too discharged. And let's not forget that with this ESC, you can simply hook up a potentiometer, calibrate it, and use it directly to adjust the speed of the motor. Awesome! And as you can see, this new system works perfectly fine and way smoother and better than with the old motor and mount.
because this time I was even able to reach an airflow of above 6 meters per second, which I never reached before. But of course, a good airflow is not everything, as I said before. And thus, I repeated the same pressure tests, only to find out that at similar power levels, my DIY design only reached around half of the distance the original motor could do. So no wonder that it didn't serve well as a vacuum cleaner. And with that being said, we can have a look at the three new impellers Marco came up with, which, after 3D printing them with PETG filaments, do look quite a bit different than my design. His blades are wider on the top because the core is more narrow, and on the bottom the diameter is slightly bigger than mine. And then of course we got the curvature of his blades and angles, which are way curvier and sharper than my design. Combine that with a newly designed top piece that stays very close to the impeller for a bigger distance than mine, and we should hopefully get better static pressure. And in case you're wondering why three new designs that at first sight all look pretty similar, then let me tell you that number 1 has the least aggressive blade angle, while number 3 has the most aggressive one. And we just want to find out whether that directly translates to more pressure. But enough with the theory, let's attach the motor to the also newly designed motor mount that can lock into the top piece very firmly, hammer on impeller number 1, put everything together and let's go for a little spin. Once again I started with the airflow tests, and let me tell you that this thing spun beautifully, and reached a new airflow high score of around 6.7 meters per second. At not even full power. So time to move on to the pressure tests. And once again, this system performed way better than my design, because it reached a distance of 35 cm at 60 watts, which sadly though is still around 10 cm lower than the original motor. But I wasn't discouraged yet, because we still got two impellers to test. And let me give you a quick summary here by saying that both performed about the same. Now the airflow was once again around the same at 6.7 meters per second, but the distance of the water at 60 watts was this time around 40 centimeter, which, yes, is not yet at the level of the original motor, but still pretty impressive in comparison to the design we started with. So all in all, here are the pressure results from all the designs. And as you might have noticed, I didn't go up to full power with the DIY ones, because that is something I wanted to experience the first time with the assembled vacuum system. And sadly, this was the moment lots of problems arose, with the first one being that the top piece of the impeller system was a bit too big for the vacuum enclosure, and thus the impeller stalled. So after cutting out some plastic pieces of the enclosure, I tried it again and the impeller stalled again. This time because due to the forces, it got pushed off the motor shaft. To fix that, I simply used some glue. And after that was dry, it seems like I was able to get close to the power limit of the system. Meaning I tried vacuuming some things. So in direct comparison, here is the old DC motor setup, and here is the BLDC motor DIY impeller thingy, which did work pretty well, but I still think the original one is still slightly more powerful. And by the way, my girlfriend agreed on the sad conclusion. Now we could theoretically cheat though, by letting the BLDC motor rotate faster, and thus let it consume more power. Which, as you can see here, reached a peak of around 140 watts for a short amount of time, at which point it was definitely capable of sucking the water higher than the original DC motor. And in case you were wondering, the ESC shut down continuously here due to safety settings, which I got rid of afterwards. But once again, this let the impeller spin so fast that it got pushed off the motor shafts. And at this point, I was already using my strongest adhesive to secure it into place. So I guess the conclusion of this video is that theoretically creating a more powerful system is definitely possible. But due to the techniques of DIYing, in my case FDM 3D printing, and lots of glue, it is practically speaking very difficult to build a reliable and more efficiently performing vacuum system. So definitely not the positive outcome I was hoping for. But you know, this is what reality looks like. And maybe for part 3 I will find a solution for all the problems. Until then, consider supporting this show through Patreon to keep it going. As always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!